guys, welcome to what could well be the final part. It's going to be a bit of a longer video than the others, so I don't know if I'll just upload this as one longer block or split it into two. But anyway, get yourself a drink, get yourself a pen and paper, because there's a few good films in here. And yeah, thank you for following me so far. Well, up until this point. So, without any further ado, let's just get the DVDs looked at. So first up is the two-disc release of The French Connection. Well, it's not the two-disc release of The French Connection, it's French Connection 1 and French Connection 2. Two really good films. Well, the first one is a masterpiece. The second one, I still really enjoyed it, but it's nowhere near as fantastic as the first film, but two very, very good films. And that was like a budget release from the UK. I think there's been like a fancy release of it, but from what I've heard, and I could be wrong, people have been complaining about like the colorization of the re-release and the remaster and that sort of stuff. But you know what? They're both uncut, so I'm happy with them. Then we've got some blank discs, which I believe these are double-sided Mill Creek discs from the it's the Hell on Wheels box set, I think it's called, from Mill Creek, which is pretty much just a lot of biker films. Stuff like Pink Angels is on there. But yeah, like most budget releases, the transfers most of the time aren't really anything to shout about, but if you want to check out some good exploitation cinema, then source these Mill Creek releases, because you can find some fantastic films that haven't been released elsewhere, or if they have, they're really hard to get hold of. Sometimes the films are cut and they're not in the right video format, or picture format I should say, but you know, if you just want to watch some good exploitation. And that's the other thing, sometimes some of the films are just absolutely dreadful, but most of the time you're in for a good time. And then the next one is the second disc from the Four Cult movie release by Shout Factory. Of course, the other films were Unholy Rollers, and I can't remember the other one, but on this one, Vicious Lips. But on this, you get Invasion of the B-Girls and The Devil's Eight. The Devil's Eight is really awesome. It's like a nice little actioner. But yeah. All great films, all of them look pretty good as well, and it's definitely a release that I highly recommend you guys pick up. Then we've got Flashdance. It's a classic. I don't see it as a guilty pleasure, I see it as a fantastic film. Great score from Giorgio Moroder, and of course some great songs on there as well. But yeah, it's a classic film. And then we've got one of the discs from the Way of the Five Finger Death Strike. Pretty much the same, along the same lines as the Mill Creek stuff, but it's all martial arts and action sort of films. Same story, some of the transfers are awful, some of them are really good, some of them are, you know, pan and scan, some are widescreen, but it's a great way to see some really good schlocky action films. Then we've got Lust for a Vampire, which is the Hammer film. I think it's Hammer. I always forget like what's a Hammer and what's an Amicus film. But yeah, vampiresses in you know, what's the word I'm looking for? Flimsy gowns. You can't ask for anything else. And speaking of which, Twins of Evil. Of course, the famous twin sisters in this film. The press photos for Twins of Evil are absolutely fantastic, by the way. You should look them up. But yeah, good, two good campy vampire films. Then we've got Samuel Jess Franco with Love Camp. Frauen im Liebeslager. From what I remember, good entertaining schlocky film. Then we've got Ben Wheatley's Kill List, a modern masterpiece, one of my favourite contemporary films. Ben Wheatley is one of my all-time favourite directors, and he's one of the very few British directors still working today that's actually making actually interesting films. Then we've got some DVD-Rs of probably cat photos and cat videos. Another double feature of Jess Franco. This time we've got Women of Cell Block 9 and Downtown. Again, both nice, sleazy little numbers. Then we've got another DVD-R, which includes On the Prowl, and all sorts of other stuff, pretty much just to make space on my MacBook. Then we've got the first of many discs sent by the BFI of the Werner Herzog collection. This one is Heart of Glass. Ah, there's Unholy Rose, even though I think I did cover this film already when I was looking at the stuff that was in the CD cases, so I don't need to talk about that. Then we've got a triple feature from Vinegar Syndrome, which is an Avon triple feature. Den of Dominance, Savage Sadists, and Daughters of Discipline. Yeah, good, nasty, mean-spirited, vulgar pieces of adult film. And yeah, hopefully Vinegar Syndrome releases more of the Avon stuff as well as more Phil Prince films, because you can't get enough Phil Prince. Another Vinegar Syndrome release, then we've got Bayou, I think that's how you pronounce it, which is a Wakefield Pool film. It's obviously gay porn, but it's very artistic, very experimental, and yeah, really enjoyable watch. So if you've got a problem with gay sex, then obviously don't watch it, but I'm, you know, comfortable enough and mature enough to watch stuff like that. Not that, you know, that's a really great quality in humanity to be able to do that, but you know what I mean. Then we've got a Spanish film called Leap Year. Picked it up mainly because it was cheap in FOP and it's got sexually explicit material in, and I like it when, you know, directors include that sort of stuff in their films. I like how they incorporate it, and I like how some of them pull it off. But yeah, Leap Year. Not actually got round to watching that one yet, so can't really talk about it. Then we've got the Arrow release of Cinema Paradiso. This is disc 1 and 2. I think it's a 4-disc set, so the 3rd disc will be around here somewhere. And obviously the 4th disc is the Ennio Morricone score. Beautiful film. Lovers of cinema need to watch that, because it's perfect for... because it's about the love of film. And a really touching story, beautifully done, and yeah, very enjoyable. Next up, we've got a couple more discs from the Five Ways of the Dragon, or Deathstrike, which I forgot to read you the titles on the other disc. So titles include, if that would like to focus, The Woman Avenger, Five Kung Fu Daredevil Heroes, Ninja Avenger, and Bravest Fist. Then here we have The Mighty Four, Blind Warrior, Ring of Death, A Hero's Tears. And then to finish off, we've got The Challenger, Triple Impact, The Rage of Wind, and Kingfisher the Killer. So, interesting titles, I think you will agree. Then we've got, there we are, the 3rd disc of Cine Paradiso. Then we've got The Raid 2 and The Raid 1. I've not actually watched The Raid 2 yet. Really loved the first Raid film. So I think a double feature is on the cards. Then we've got the BFI release of Sallow, one of my all-time favourite films, and there's the 2nd disc. Then we've got the Blue Underground DVD of Deep Red. This is the uncensored English version. Watched this for the first time in a long time the other day, and yeah, what a really visually astounding film. So many great close-up shots in this. Not my favourite Giallo, not my favourite Argento film, but still a damn good film, and the Goblin score is just perfect. Then we've got Lars von Trier's Dancer in the Dark, starring Bjork, who I can't stand Bjork, but she's really good in this film. Again, antagonistic cinema from Lars von Trier. Then we've got another budget release. This is the Mafia Kingpin Collection Volume 2, which includes The Cynic, The Rat, The Fist, The Violent... what's that? I can't read that. Oh, The Master Touch and Violent Naples. The best films on this disc are The Cynic, The Rat, The Fist, my favourite Polizio Tesci film, and Violent Naples, both of them starring Maurizio Merli. Why does that name sound wrong to me? Yeah, I always like lose all strain of consciousness while I'm, you know, doing these videos, so that's why I'm all over the place. Then we've got The American Friend, directed by Wim Wenders, starring Dennis Hopper and, I can never remember, Bruno Ganz. Fantastic film, absolutely fantastic. Then we've got a little bit of Fellini with Amarcord, which I've like watched half of it. For some reason, didn't watch all of it, so I have to revisit that at some point. I'm seriously lacking Fellini films. This is the only Fellini film that I've got in the collection, but hopefully I'll be able to pick some up soon. Then we've got a couple more Fassbinder films. We've got The Bitter Tears and The Merchant of Four Seasons, both of them still yet to watch. Then we've got Hot and Saucy Pizza Girls, starring John Holmes, Desiree Custo, and directed by Bob Chin. Really fun, weird piece of adult cinema. Highly, highly recommended. Vinegar Syndrome did a great job on that release. Then we've got a bit of Italian neorealism with Bicycle Thieves. Just shows you how Italy suffered post-war, well, post-World War II. Yeah, it's basically about a guy who, to make money, he gets a job putting posters up on walls, and he obviously needs a bicycle to get around the town because he can't afford a car. Basically, his bicycle gets stolen, and then he goes around trying to find his bicycle. He basically, yeah, it's a hard watch in places. I won't spoil it, but yeah, great, great little film. Then we've got another Fernando de Leo film with The Naked Violence, which I think is the film about a group of school children rape and kill their teacher in class, and it's about the detective interviewing the children. Yeah, some really interesting visuals in that film, if it's the right one. I always forget what film is what. But yeah, both Fernando de Leo box sets from Rare Video are absolutely fantastic and essential. Then we've got a documentary about Krzysztof Kieślowski, which comes in the Three Colours Trilogy box set from Artificial Eye. Been a long time since I've watched that, so I can't really comment on it too much. Then we've got a couple more Fassbinder films, Beware of the Holy Whore and Rio Des Mortes. And then the final two from the Fernando de Leo box set, two with Shoot First, Die Later, and then The Kidnap Syndicate. These two are more action than Naked Violence, and I think they both star Luke Miranda as well. Fantastic films, highly recommended. Then we've got my favourite, Polizia Teschi, The Cynic, the Rat, the Fist, directed by Umberto Lenzi and starring Maurizio Merli, Thomas Millian, and Henry Silva. No, not Henry Silva. Oh my god, I forgot his name from Nightmare on Elm Street. John Saxon. How did I get him mixed up with Henry Silva? But yeah, fantastic film. This is the somewhat hard to get camera obscura release. No, it's film art release from Germany. But if you pick up the Mafia Kingpin box set with this film on, the transfer's not as good, but it is widescreen. It is fully uncut, and it's a very watchable transfer. So if that's kind of putting you off, and for a fraction of the price, you can watch that and a few other good films from the genre. Highly, highly recommended. Then we've got Ma Mère, which is a French film starring Isabelle Huppert. Basically, she stars as a wife and a mother who, after her husband dies, she basically, with her son, they have like a sexual discovery. Where she's basically trying to hook him up with her friend, and you know, they're going to like these nightclubs and that sort of thing, and of course he ends up getting with his own mother. But yeah, got a really interesting ending. Aside from that, not the most engaging or entertaining film. Then we've got some more DVD-R goodness, of just files that I have, and then the Shameless disc of Almost Human, which does star Henry Silva, and also stars Thomas Millian as well. Fantastic film, brutal in places, some really great set pieces, and it's a good actioner as well. So then we've got The Bothersome Man, which is a really intriguing little film. I did an episode of Cinema Europa on it, so if you want to find out more, the link is going to be in the description, because words escape me right now. Then we've got the German disc of What Have They Done to Your Daughters. This disc is slightly cut from what I can gather compared to the Shameless release and other releases. But I picked this DVD up, and it comes in a really gorgeous, like, cardboard digipack with a slipcase. And it was like €7, so I couldn't turn it down. And I basically sold my Shameless one, and I had enough money to buy this one and some change, so I'm not going to say no to that. But yeah, great little film, part of the Schoolgirls in Terror trilogy, the other films being What Have They Done to Solange, and I can't remember the final film of the trilogy. I don't think they're connected at all, but yeah, great little film. Got Mario Adorf in there as well. Then we've got Three Colors Red, which is of course from the Three Colors trilogy. I'd say it's probably my second favourite out of the trilogy. Then we've got Control, which is another piece of European contemporary cinema, basically set in an underground railway station. It's one of these like bleak films that has dark comedy and it's got drama and yeah, interesting visuals and soundtrack as well. Then we've got Street Law, the Enzo G. Castellari masterpiece starring Franco Nero. This is one of those films that is just insanely watchable. There's just something about it. It's full of action. Got a great score from the De Angelis brothers. And yeah, absolutely fantastic film. And yeah, so I'm going to leave this video here, mainly because Jeannie's just arrived. And yeah, I shall see you in the final part. So I'm recording this like the day after the first part of this video, but I'm just going to have it as one long video. So yeah, hope you've got yourself a drink or something, because it's probably going to take a little bit longer. Anyway, so I covered Street Law, fantastic Enzo G. Castellari film. Got that as part of a free pack from Blue Underground. It's part of their like action from the Midnight Movies series, and it's like the action box set, which includes The Big Racket, and I can't remember the name of the other film, but it's basically a trio of Enzo G. Castellari films, and for the price that you're paying for it, definitely, definitely worth the money, especially just for this film alone. I absolutely love this film. Heroin Busters, The Big Racket, and Street Law. That's what you got in the set, I think. Next we've got Three Colors White, Krzysztof Kieślowski, and my favourite of the trilogy. I like how dark it can be, but it's got drama as well, it's funny, it's just a really well executed film with a really interesting story and great performances. Then we've got the German disc of Umberto Lenzi's Eyeball. This is from, I can't remember the name of the DVD label, let me see, I can't see that properly through the protective sleeve. Let's quickly take that out. This is from Marketing Film in Germany, which is like a budget, well, not really a budget, because you pay a pretty penny for some of their releases. They're not the best of transfers. In fact, the video for this DVD isn't the greatest, and the English audio, because you get, I think you get the German audio and the English audio. I think you might also get the Italian audio on the disc as well. But the English audio for this film is very, very muddy. But I believe it's the only way you can actually watch this film on a legitimate disc. I could be wrong about that, so please let me know if I am, because I'd love to upgrade this film, because I'd say it's an underappreciated giallo from Umberto Lenzi. Got a great score from Bruno Nicolai. I think that's who scored this one. But yeah, nice little film. And yeah, if you source the German disc, or indeed a much more superior disc, then pick it up, because it's definitely worth it. Then we've got another Blue Underground release. This is of The Mad Dog Killer. This is like a Euro crime sort of outing with, I forgot his name. He was also in The Night Porter, I believe. I can't remember. But this is quite a vicious little film, actually. Very, very mean-spirited. And yeah, just a really damn good film. It's a film that I actually have to revisit. So, and here we go. We've got The Big Racket and Heroin Busters. Again, two Enzo G. Castellari films come in the Midnight Movies action box set. For the price that you're paying for them, like I said, definitely worth the money. And yeah, two outstanding films. But Street Law is my favourite of those three films. But they're still very, very good. Then we've got Naked Came the Stranger, which I think is the actual film disc and not the extras disc. Henry Paris, put out by DistroPix. You can actually pick up a really gorgeous box set from DistroPix of the Henry Paris films, beautifully presented and beautifully restored as well. DistroPix and Vinegar Syndrome have done some absolutely fantastic restorations, and yeah, they really show that you can preserve and release even lesser known and lesser appreciated titles to the, you know, the level that Hollywood is doing with their like 4K restorations and such. But yeah, fantastic little film. And then we've got Three Colors Blue, which stars Juliette Binoche, I think that's her name. God, my misinformation is terrible when I'm doing these videos. I apologize about that. This is probably my least favorite out of the Three Colors trilogy, but still a really interesting film if you want to check out some 90s international drama. And then we've got the opening of Misty Beethoven, Disc One, Pamela Mann, The Private Life of Pamela Mann, Disc One, and Barbara Broadcast, Disc One, and then Maraschino Cherry, Disc One. Again, all the Henry Paris films. Definitely worth picking up if you want to get into classic adult cinema. And like I was saying, those releases are absolutely gorgeous. Then we've got Takeshi Kitano in Violent Cop. I really enjoyed this film. Picked up really cheap from FOP, I believe. And yeah, some good solid kung fu. Hong Kong action. Yeah, an outstanding little film. And definitely worth checking out. Then we've got The Double Life of Veronique. This is Disc One. A two-disc set that was actually sent to me by a viewer a while ago, whose name escapes me. I'm not sure if he's still on YouTube, actually, but he sent me quite a few discs. He also sent me La Haine as well. So, you know, I got to check out some really intriguing films. And this is another Krzysztof Kieślowski film. Really interesting film. Great concept. It's about a woman who, I think she like sees herself, and yeah, it's been a hell of a long time since I watched it, but I really did enjoy it. I think I actually did a review of this a long, long time ago on the channel. Then we've got some more Werner Herzog review discs from BFI. This is of Cobra Verde, one that I haven't actually seen yet. Yeah, I'm terrible when it comes to my review discs. A lot of them I still actually need to watch. And as I'm recording this video, I'm actually writing a review for Arrow's release of Day of Anger, which was released in 2015. So really late to the party on some of my review discs. But yeah, anyway, still need to see that one. Then we've got Frozen Land, one that I watched recently. This is a fantastic film. It's again one of those like bleak dramas, but it's got some really intriguing dark humour there. And yeah, just a really interesting film about a whole, you know, range of different characters who they're all connected by the actions of the main character. And it shows you the knock-on effect of what he does, and then it cuts to their lives, and then it cuts back to him, and cuts to someone else. Really interesting film. It sort of reminds me of a mixture of Import-Export and 71 Chronologies of, you know, the Mike Haneke film. Yeah, but really intriguing film. Picked this up again, dirt cheap from FOP. Well worth the £3 that I paid for it, brand new. Fantastic film, and I'll definitely be covering that on Cinema Europa at some point. There we've got some more review discs, all of them Werner Herzog titles. Won't go into too much detail about them because they're only review discs. We've got Strutsek, again, haven't seen that yet. Burden of Dreams, which is the documentary about Herzog's Fitzcarraldo. Again, still need to watch that. Hope the people at BFI aren't watching this video. And then we've got Fitzcarraldo, fantastic film with Klaus Kinski. And then Wojciech, which I think I have actually seen that one, shock horror. Then we've got Nosferatu the Vampire, and then the German version of Nosferatu. I prefer the German version because they get the subtitles wrong. My German is limited, but there'll be times where they'll have phrases or sentences that don't actually match up to the German dialogue. And yeah, but both of them, fantastic films. And it's actually my favourite adaptation of, Dracula. Then we've got another cheap German disc of, what's the film called? Little Darlings, which I found out from Robin Bougie. So I watched like a download of it, and then I found out that there was a German company doing a release of this, and I had to pick it up because it's a fantastic film. There's just something about it that is fantastic. Yeah, this needs a proper legitimate special edition release. It seriously does. Shout Factory, Arrow, get this film released properly. Then we've got another Villeneuve Syndrome title. This time it's Prisoner of Paradise, starring Sica and John Holmes. Nice piece of kind of Nazi exploitation. Definitely worth picking up. It's one of the Vinegar Syndrome releases where it's just the film. So it's not like two films on one disc. So you get some nice special features and yeah, really nice restoration as well. Then we've got a bootleg that I picked up from, I can't remember the company's name, is it ZWD back in the UK? Yeah, pretty much you can download the film, but I picked up a disc because they actually put artwork on it and that sort of thing. Maurizio Merli film, I can't remember too much about it. I think Hugo Stiglitz stars in this one as well. I definitely have to revisit that because I am actually working on a Maurizio Merli article going through his crime filmography, and that's one of his lesser known films, so I need to revisit that one. That disc, I have no idea what's on there. Then we've got disc two of The Double Life of Veronique. Then we've got August Underground's release of Torso. This was one of the first Giallo films that I ever watched, and I wasn't that big of a fan of it, to be honest. But obviously, repeat viewings, I've come to appreciate the film a lot more, and obviously through the fact that I've watched a lot more Gialli. Yeah, I used to have the Shameless release, but picked this up really cheap when I was doing my dissertation on Giallo films. There we've got some more Vinegar Syndrome with a double feature, Malin versus Serena and Oriental Hawaii. Two interesting films from Carlos Tobelina, who's notorious for making shit films. But I don't know, I'm a glutton for punishment when it comes to Tobelina, and he sort of reminds me of like a full-on porn version of Bruno Mattei. But yeah, two interesting films. I mean, Serena, you can't go wrong. Then we've got Convoy Busters, starring Maurizio Merli. This is the No Shame disc. Scored this really cheap when I was doing my dissertation on Giallo films. I had like a run of buying really cheap Giallo films on Amazon, and I was like watching so many because I was writing about it on my end of university dissertation. So I really lucked out on a lot of Giallo films and crime films, because this isn't a Giallo, this is a Polizio Tesci. It's not the most memorable, but it's still got some good action sequences. Then we've got disc one and two of 24 Hour Party People, my favourite film of all time. I've talked about that film so many times, so I won't talk about it anymore. Then we've got Rats Night of Terror, which is the Bruno Mattei film released on Another World Entertainment. I know Blue Underground recently released Hell of the Living Dead and Rats as a Blu-ray double feature. So there are better versions out there, but I'm perfectly fine with this disc. And Psychotronic Broadcast, Jack here on YouTube, actually wrote the liner notes for this release. So yeah, interesting film. So campy, so trashy, but fantastic. Then we've got Hot Night of Linda, which I already showed the first disc, but this is a bonus disc that was like limited to 1,000, which it's basically just like the French VHS version of the film. Still haven't got around to watching it yet, but I absolutely love that artwork on the disc. Severin did a fantastic job with that release. Then we've got Beautiful, starring Javier Bardem, directed by the guy who, Hollywood loves him now. The guy, I can never remember his name, he directed The Revenant and Oscar darling, and this is one of his first films, which I've had this disc for years, but never got around to watching it. Then we've got Emmanuel, Queen of Sados, otherwise known as Emmanuel Queen Bitch. I don't know how this was really released legitimately, because it involves a girl who is clearly underage, but you see her naked so many times. There's a rape scene involving her as well. It is like, without being actual child pornography, it's probably the most, it's sick. It's genuinely sick, and this is coming from a jaded exploitation film fan. It was hard to watch because the girl in this film is like 14 years old, and she's, being paraded as if she was like Edward Finesse. It's just, it's a weird, weird film, and obviously stars Laura Gemsler. Then we've got Good Luck, Mrs. Vickoff, or Miss Vickoff, which is released by Vinegar Syndrome. I got sent this disc by Kulfi here on YouTube. It was just a loose disc. He sent it me in trade. Really interesting, racially aware film. Definitely worth checking out. Then we've got Michael, which is, I did a video of this on Cinema Europa. It's basically about a guy who kidnaps a child because he's a paedophile, and it shows you their relationship. And again, it's got like some really uncomfortable moments and some sequences where you're like, should I really be laughing at this humour? Very questionable film, not for everyone, but I thought it was a really well done drama, actually. And it's not graphic or anything like that, so don't worry, but powerful little film. Then we've got My Dear Killer, which is another giallo. This is released by Shriekshow. Haven't watched this fully, to be honest. I don't know why, I've just never really sat down and watched it properly. I've got halfway through, then gone on to something else. I know Shameless released this as well, but I picked this disc up really cheap. Then we've got A Woman Possessed, another loose disc that was sent to me by Kulfi. It's like a French, like, witchcraft film, I'm not too sure. I haven't watched it yet, I don't know why, I'll have to get that watched. Then we've got Vampiros Lesbos, which was sent to me by Severin. Fantastic Jess Franco film, starring the absolutely gorgeous Soledad Miranda. And then another DVD-R that I bought from the company that did Vultures Over the City. This is Seagulls Fly Low, again starring Maurizio Merli. And you could probably find a download that's probably even nicer than the picture quality. But it came in artwork and it was really cheap. And but I don't really buy bootlegs because I just don't really see the sense in it most of the time. In trades, I think it's fine, to buy them, not my thing. But then again, there are some films, if I was to have them all displayed, that I would probably buy from this company, because it's great service, and the more you buy, the more points you get, so then you can get a free film, and you get discounts to buy multiple films. So if you are of the type of person who wants, the actual artwork and stuff, and to have it displayed, then this company is really good. I'll have to put their proper URL down below. But yeah, that was my DVD overview for 2016. Thank you for sticking with me through these videos. Thank you so much for the comments, even though at this point I've only just uploaded part 2. And if you want to find out more about any of the films, feel free to ask me any questions. Any of the films that I have reviewed, I'll put links down below. And of course, let me know your thoughts and opinions on any of the films that you have seen that have been mentioned here. So, if I buy other stuff throughout the year, which I probably will, I'll probably wait till like there's a good bunch of them and that I've actually watched. So then if I've not enjoyed them, I've sold the ones on that I've not enjoyed, then I can actually get, other parts of this collection uploaded. And thanks for watching, and I shall see you in whatever the next video may be.